This is the VOA Special English Technology Report. Falling prices are fueling growth in high-speed internet services, especially in developing countries. Recently, the International Telecommunication Union released its Measuring the Information Society 2011 report. The ITU, part of the United Nations, compared access, use, and skills in 152 countries. The report says South Korea has the world's most developed economy in information and communication technology, or ICT. Sweden, Iceland, Denmark, and Finland were also among the top five in the ICT Development Index. The index compares 2008 and 2010 scores. Saudi Arabia, Morocco, Vietnam, and Russia had some of the biggest improvements between those years. Susan Teltscher is head of the ICT Data and Statistics Division at the International Telecommunication Union in Switzerland. She says most of the growth has come from one source. Mobile broadband is now leading the growth race among the different ICT indicators, much higher than the other key indicators that we look at, like regular mobile phone subscriptions, fixed telephone, or fixed broadband. And the good news is that it's also starting to grow in developing countries. Mobile broadband subscriptions reached 872 million by the end of last year. 300 million of those are in developing countries. Ms. Teltscher says, if we can bring internet over the mobile phones, then we can really make a difference in terms of improving internet access also in developing countries. Falling prices are adding to the growth, she says, especially in the broadband area. The prices dropped by over 50% between 2008 and 2010, which is a very encouraging finding because this was primarily drops in the developing countries. Even so, the report says people in many low-income countries are still paying too much for high-speed internet connections. In Africa, broadband service for a home or office cost almost three times an average monthly income last year. That was down from 6.5 times as much in 2008. Also, there are big differences in broadband speed and quality from country to country. South Korea has Asia's fourth largest economy. Susan Teltscher says, if you look at what they have been achieving in terms of ICT development, it's actually higher than what you would expect given their national income. For VOA Special English, I'm Carolyn Presutti.